Hello everybody, I am Dr. S.K. Mittal. In this lecture, I will consider the use of nodal analysis to calculate current flowing through various branches using nodal analysis consisting of dependent and independent sources. For this, I have considered a circuit. In this circuit, I have to calculate current in each branch using nodal analysis method. Means the circuit is consisting of three resistances, 1 ohm, 0.5 ohm and this 0.5 ohm. I have to calculate current in these resistances using the nodal analysis method. But see the circuit diagram. This circuit diagram is consisting of two independent current sources, 3 ampere and 2 ampere. At the same time, one dependent source or dependent current source, which is depending upon current I2, which is flowing in 0.5 ohm. Before applying the nodal analysis, I want to consider one fundamental. Suppose it is a diamond structure. In electrical engineering, diamond structure is represented to show the dependent sources. If arrow is represented, then these dependent sources become the dependent current sources. If the value of this dependent source is K into I, where K is a constant and current I is flowing in any branch of the circuit, therefore it is known as current dependent current source. At the same time, if a diamond structure is considered and in this diamond structure arrow is written, then I have already told it is dependent current source. And suppose value is written like this, K into V, then it is voltage dependent current source. Therefore, in this circuit, 2I2 is current dependent current source, because in this diamond structure there is arrow and it is a dependent current source and its value is depending upon current I2, which is flowing in this 0.5 ohm resistance. To apply the nodal analysis to calculate the current flowing through each branch, I will draw the circuit diagram. This is 0.5 ohm resistance. Current is I2. Here is current dependent current source. Value is 2I2. Here is 0.5 ohm resistance. And it is the current source of 2 ampere. You can draw like this. And this is the 1 ohm resistance and the current source may be represented like this. So this is the circuit diagram. This circuit diagram is used to calculate current in different resistances using the nodal analysis method. Therefore, in case of nodal analysis method, we first of all investigate the number of junctions. Here, this point is a junction because 1, 2, 3, 4 elements are connected here. This is also a junction. 1, 2, 3, 4 elements are joined. It becomes junction number 1. It becomes junction number 2. And see, this is the line of conducting wire. And at this conducting wire, at this point, two elements are connected. At this point, two elements are connected. Since potential of this conducting wire is same at every point, therefore this may be considered at one point, and therefore this may be considered also a junction, and this becomes the third junction. But in case of nodal analysis, if junctions are three, then the bottom junction is considered at the reference junction, whereas junction 1 and 2 are considered as independent junctions. Then number of nodal equations according to nodal analysis method is equal to number of independent junctions. Therefore, nodal equations are 2. Therefore, in this circuit, these are the independent junctions 1 and 2. After deciding this, we will consider two node voltages between 1 and reference V1 and other node voltage will be considered between point 2 and reference. Therefore, V1 and V2 are the node voltages. Since there are two node voltages, therefore two equations should be written in terms of V1 and V2 at independent node number 1 and independent node number 2. To write the nodal equations at independent nodes 1 and 2, first of all, it is required to represent the currents in various branches of the circuit. In this 0.5 ohm I2 current is already given. I will consider this current I3 in downward direction. In this 0.5, I will consider I4. Therefore, you can see in every branch I have represented the current. Therefore, to write the nodal equations, there will be two nodal equations since independent nodes are 2. Now, nodal equation 1. It will be written at independent node number 1. See, independent node number 1, at this node, 4 currents are associated, 3 ampere, I3, I2 and 2I2. Therefore, at node number 1, I3 is entering, I2, 2I2 and I3 all are outgoing. Therefore, for incoming current, I will write positive sign, so then it will be plus 3 minus I2 minus I3 minus 2I2 is equal to 0. This should be written in terms of Kirchhoff's current law. Therefore, by solving, we can say that it will be I2 plus I3 is equal to 3. But it is to be noted that the nodal equations which are written at points 1 and 2 must be in terms of node voltages V1 and V2. Therefore, it becomes necessary to convert I2 and I3 of this equation number 2 in terms of V1 and V2. See the circuit. I2 is flowing from point 1 to 2. At point 1, node voltage is V1. At point 2, node voltage is V2. If I consider this as reference, then it will be V1, it will be V2, and for this current polarity across 0.5 volt will be like this. And if write KVL for this, it will be 0.5 I2. For this sign, I will write positive. For V2, in this direction of calculation, plus, and after this, minus V1 is equal to 0. Therefore, by solving this, I will write I2 is equal to 2V1 minus V2. Therefore, I2 I have calculated in terms of V1 and V2. See the I3. I3 is flowing in 1 ohm resistance from point 1 to reference. To calculate I3 according to circuit, I will make one reference. It is I3, resistance is 1 ohm, and between 1 and reference there is a node voltage V1. Then according to KVL, it is plus V1 minus 1 into I3 is equal to 0. Therefore, I3 is equal to 1 into V1. Therefore, value of I2 and I3 obtained in equations 4 and 6, I will put in equation number 2. Therefore, putting the value of I2 and I3 in equation number 2, 3, value of I2 is 2V1 minus V2 plus I3, value of I3 is 1 into V3 is equal to 3, and by collecting the terms of V1, V2 and V3, value of V1 and V2, the final equation will be 7V1 minus 6V2 is equal to 3. This is the first nodal equation. This is the first nodal equation, and see, this nodal equation is written in terms of nodal node voltages V1 and V2. Now, nodal equation at 2. See the circuit diagram at point 2. I2, 2I2, I4 and 2 ampere currents are associated. I2, 2I2 and 2 ampere are incoming. Therefore, writing KCL plus I2 plus 2I2 minus I4 plus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, after solving, it will be 3I2 minus I4 is equal to minus 2. But it is to be noted that this KCL must be in terms of node voltages V1 and V2. I have already calculated the value of I2 in equation number 4, and to calculate the value of I4, we may consider this circuit. I4 is flowing from 2 to reference. Therefore, if I write KVL, then it will be plus V2 minus 0.5 I4 is equal to 0, and therefore I4 is equal to V2 divided by 0.5 means 2 V2. The KCL which I obtained for independent node is 3I2 minus I4 is equal to minus 2. Then in this equation, I will put the value of I2 and I4. The value of I2 is 2 V1 minus V2. The value of I4 is 2 V2 and it is equal to minus 2. Therefore, collecting the terms of V1 and V2, this equation becomes 6 V1 minus 8 V2 is equal to minus 2. This equation number 14 becomes the nodal equation of independent node 2. Therefore, by solving the equation 8, first nodal equation, and equation number 14, second nodal equation, V1 is equal to 1.8 volt and V2 is equal to 1.6 volt, you may apply any method such as elimination method and Cramer's rule. You can obtain the value of V1 and V2, but we have to calculate current flowing through each branch. See this circuit. Current in this 1 ohm is I3, and the value of I3 which is equal to current flowing through 1 ohm is equal to 1 into V1 is equal to 1 into 1.8 is equal to 1.8 ampere. Current flowing through this 0.5 ohm is I2, is equal to 2V1 minus V2 is equal to 2 multiplied by 1.8 minus 1.6 is equal to 0.4 volt. At the same time, value of current I4 which is flowing through 0.5 ohm, it is equal to 2 multiplied by V2 is equal to 2 multiplied by 1.6 is equal to 3.2 ampere. In this way, I have calculated I3, the current flowing through 1 ohm of the circuit, this 1 ohm. Current flowing through 0.5 ohm is I2. it is 0.4 ampere and current flowing through I4, current flowing through this 0.5 ohm is I4, which is equal to 2V2 is equal to 3.2 ampere. In this way, we can apply the nodal analysis to calculate the current flowing through various resistances if dependent and independent both sources are present in the circuit. Thank you.